Camille Komine has worked on big Hollywood productions as a buyer and food stylist. But earlier this year, she decided to take her passion for cooking on the road. And now customers are eating it up, from Kakaako to Kailua.
My name's Camille Komine. I'm the owner of Camille's on Wheels, and I'm a career changer. I was born and raised in Los Angeles, and I worked in the film business for 27 years between Hollywood and then Hawaii. I was a little hippie chick that lived down in Encinitas, and I worked in restaurants, and I started cooking in restaurants in San Diego in the 70s. When I got into the film business, I realized that I still had this passion for cooking, which I've always done, and I worked as a makeup artist, a wardrobe person, and then I got into the art department where I stayed for quite a while. I'm also a food stylist, which made the transition back into the food business pretty fluid and easy. Well, in the last few years, I've worked on the Clint Eastwood movie, Hereafter. One of the last big jobs I had was a big banquet scene for the George Clooney movie, Descendants. I got out of the film business last year, and the impetus to do it was based on some personal loss, both of my fathers, my stepdad and my real father. The other reason I decided to leave the film business was it stopped being fun. The creative side of the business, the artistic aspect that I love so much was quickly becoming second to the politics of the business. And I found that people weren't being nice to each other. I also realized that this thing called life is so short that if you're not doing what you love, you're kind of wasting your time. So I've always had this huge passion for food, and I decided to go for it, and I thought, I'm doing this. The biggest challenges in starting my own business was getting to a place where I trusted my abilities and myself and that I could do it. There's some physical challenges to running a business. You have to load your truck up every morning, you have to unload it every day, you have to clean it, you then have to prep for the next day, so it's a lot of physical work. You also have to be attached to a commercial kitchen or a commissary, so you have to go somewhere to prepare all your food. Those are some of the challenges. Understanding what's required to run a food truck, the special permits and licensing that you need, those are some other challenges. Weather, obviously, when it rains, you just pretty much don't open. Another thing that I've done is I have been working with Peter Merriman. He really started the farm-to-table movement in Hawaii. As a result, I got very excited about the idea of using local products in my food. It's a slow process for me to try and find local produce that works in my food, but I like to go to the farmers market at least once or twice a week and pick up as much as I can. I serve global tacos, so I take cuisines from around the world and put them into tacos. I run specials and I bake my own pies and desserts. People are really drawn to the comfort food. They're really drawn to my meatloaf and my homemade pies. The best way to find me is Camille's on Wheels, and on Twitter, I'm Camille's on Wheel. And I'm in town 3 days a week, and I'm in Kailua 2 days a week, Wednesday and Saturday. And everything's been social media and word of mouth, and I'm kind of blown away at where I am. It's been incredible. One of the most wonderful things that's come out of just this whole word of mouth thing is that I'm going to be on the cooking channel's Eat Street, so I expect a lot of response from that. I am having so much fun and meeting so many wonderful people. And that's the surprise of this, is how many really